In today's video, we will explain what happens when the UVW connections on the PCB or compressor are connected incorrectly. We'll cover the advantages and disadvantages of this in today's video. As you can see here, these UVW connections are in place, and we will demonstrate reversing them and explain the consequences. Today, we will share our experience with you. Now, we will show you that the UVW connections are correctly positioned in their respective places. W is blue, V is white, and U is red. These wires are connected in this manner. Similarly, when we look at the compressor, you can see that I have already opened it. Here, V is white, U is red, and W is blue. Now we will start this unit and show you how it operates when the connections are correct and how it behaves when they are incorrect. When everything is correct, it will operate smoothly. However, we want to demonstrate what happens when the connections are incorrect. So first, I will change the connections. I will swap V and W. You can see here V is white and U is red. I have exchanged these connections. Now I will power it up and observe the results. The standing pressure of the refrigerant is 220 psi. Once the compressor starts, we will see what issue arises. The unit has started and its lights are also on. When we turn it on, we will let it run for a short time, not too long, because we've faced damage in the past. This demonstration is only to show you what kind of damage can occur due to incorrect connections. Now, as you can see, the unit has started, but the compressor is not functioning at all. It's begun to jerk and vibrate. We are now turning off the unit. You can clearly observe the damage caused when we exchanged U and V connections. The compressor started jerking and then completely shut down. This is the kind of damage that occurs due to such incorrect connections. Now, if V and W are exchanged, what happens? I will now disconnect and swap V and W. Notice that the wires have also started to heat up, which can potentially damage both the PCB and the compressor. I have now changed the wires. White is on W and blue is on V, with W back in its original position. Let me show you the damage this can cause as well. Now, as you can see, the unit has started and it has begun drawing some amperes. The compressor has started as well, but it has begun jerking. You may not notice it, but I can tell the unit is vibrating, so we immediately turned it off. This is what happens when the terminals are switched. The unit starts jerking, and in some cases, it doesn't work at all. Similarly, we have another brand to show you, and we'll demonstrate the kind of damage it causes in that as well. Now, let me show you that we have a 1-ton O-General unit. But first, I will show you its correct connection positions. If I don't show you the correct positions first, it will be hard for you to understand the changes when I swap them. These are the U, V, and W connections in place. We will now turn it on and check its pressure. Afterward, I will intentionally make wrong connections and show you what happens to the unit in that situation. Now, as you can see, the unit has started, and this is how it operates when the connections are correct. Observing this is very important to understand its proper functioning. Make sure to remember these correct connections so that you don't face any issues later on. The unit is working perfectly. Both the output and input pressures are functioning smoothly. This demonstrates how efficiently it works with the correct connections. Now look, we have restarted the unit, but this time the compressor connections are incorrect. The compressor is vibrating, and if we check the discharge and suction lines, there is no pressure at all. At this moment, the unit is running without any pressure. Both lines show no activity, and if you're wondering about the valves, they are fully open. Both valves are completely open, yet there is no pressure. Additionally, the sound of the unit is entirely different from its normal operation. What's happening here is that the compressor's pump inside is running in reverse, which is why no pressure is being generated. This is what happens when the connections are incorrect. So, whenever you make connections, ensure they are done properly and accurately to avoid such issues. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.